Let's take a look at how sound works. Say a bird starts singing, and this travels through the air as a sound wave before reaching the ear. The sound wave is an analog signal, but in order to represent it on a computer, we need to convert it to digital information. After it's converted to digital, we might want to perform some audio transforms on it, change the volume, or apply some other echo effect, or something much more complicated and awesome. We can think of all these transforms as a graph of processing nodes that each transform our sound in some way, and you can put them together. Then that's exactly how web audio is structured. In this case, you can take the sound and run it through a series of nodes to transform it into, for example, a slapback echo effect. Let's take a look at the Web Audio Playground, which is a web application built by Chris Wilson. It's a great way to visualize how web audio works, and you can actually play around with all the different nodes. You can create source nodes and add all these different processing nodes to your sound. And you can create that same slapback effect like this.
Hello.
Now, web audio is a node graph that is contained in something called an audio context. Everything in the audio context is run natively in high-performance code, specifically designed for audio processing. Of course, what we see here is a simple example. A real node graph may look quite complicated, but ultimately it's all using the same concepts.